You can't embrace your destiny while you're holding on to your history. You got to let it go. When Paul the Apostle was on an island and he was ministering to some people, in fact, he was in prison. He was on a ship. He was going to share the gospel, and he had been in prison for sharing the gospel, and they landed on this island. He had been through a lot of pain, a lot of tough things. People had hurt him. He's standing around this bonfire in Acts 28, and as he's standing around the bonfire, this snake, a viper, jumps out of the fire, latches hold of his arm. Now, Paul doesn't wait 30 minutes to shake it off. He doesn't wait a year to shake it off. As soon as it latches hold, shakes it off. The other thing that Paul doesn't do, right after the snake bit him, Paul didn't start a campaign against the snake. He didn't say, I'm really angry at that bonfire. I'm going to start another bonfire over here. I don't like the people on that island. I'm going to another island over here. No, in fact, it says Paul stayed right where the snake bit him. What? He stayed in the same place where a snake bit him? Why wouldn't he leave? Why wouldn't he start another church, go somewhere else, divide everybody up, bring some people on his team to go against the snake? Because Paul knew this. No matter how long he stands around yelling at the snake, angry at the snake, not forgiving the snake, he's going to miss the destiny that God had for him on that island. God has a destiny for you in this church, in this marriage, in this family. You can yell at the snake all day, but it's not going to help you. You can stay angry at the snake all day, or you could choose to let it go, because God says, I've got too much big stuff for you to stand around campaigning against the snake. Just let it go. If I've offended you as the pastor of this church, I am sorry. I ask for your forgiveness. You say, well, Paul, it's not really you. It's the other people. If they've offended you, let me apologize for them. We're sorry. Let it go. If someone in your family has hurt you, say, well, Paul, I'm not going to forgive them until they come and apologize to me. Don't put your life on hold and give the power to somebody else for you to have peace. It's time for you to have your peace and your joy back. Don't wait till they come to you. Let it go. Drop it off. Get rid of it. I'm thankful for my parents setting an example for me of always walking in forgiveness. You know, you learn the behavior of how you handle offenses. How you handle offenses will determine the next 30 years of your life. You can't avoid offenses, they're gonna come at you. Jesus said, as long as you're breathing, you'll be tempted to be offended. When you walk out of church today, you'll be tempted. Some of you might already be tempted to be offended by my sermon about not getting offended right now. That's how the devil works.